Hi, today's lesson, good photos in two clicks. Action! I recently was talking to a photographer online and he was telling me that he was shooting manual and I was like, whoa, that's a good thing to do. Shoot manual is one of the best ways to control your camera. And then as we progressed throughout the conversation, I came to realize that for every successful photo that he took, he had to take 11 to 15 shots. And that was the reason why he was talking to me, where he went wrong. And that's the important lesson we want to learn here today. Shooting manual is a good achievement. It's a good way to progress. It gets you to work on your exposure to be spot on. But having more than 3 clicks to get a photo to be nice, it's not good. Let me explain why. The few ways that you can fail in photography: exposure, focus, and composition. Let's talk about your exposure, where it's very frequent for people to do trial and error. That means they're taking like 10 to 20 shots to get one nice shot. They can be taking shots that over, under, very over, very under, almost okay, not too simple. Take a look at this photo. I could have made mistake in two areas. I could make this underexposed or overexposed. I'm not gonna even talk about composition or focusing yet. Just exposure. Now let's start with underexposure. If you follow me here, you'll be able to take good photos in two clicks or under. Underexposed. Let me quickly take a shot here and show you the three levels of exposure mistakes that you can get. Let's take a look at the correct one first. Take a look at this shot. Correct exposure. And then take a look at this shot. It's underexposed. Though mildly underexposed. I'm not gonna even entice you with a histogram or talk to you about histogram. Just take a look at this photo, you realize that it's a little bit underexposed. The next level of underexposure, obvious underexposure, which means that you show it to anybody, they will go like, I think it's a little bit dark. And then this one, this is horrendously underexposed that I'm wondering, why are you not signing up my e-learning courses and learn about exposure? This is so underexposed that I could go on and say that you should might want to consider about giving. I'm not going to do that. So you have three grades of underexposure. So that's it. Take a look at the photo you have just clicked. The one click you did before this. See where it falls. Is it a little bit underexposed? Obvious underexposed? Or, I got to give up photography. Which one? Simple. If it is this underexposure, you're one stop underexposed. This, you are two stops underexposed. This means you're three or more than three stops underexposed. So that's an easy way. No reason for you to take the next shot wrong again, which means that if your ISO is 100 and you get this shot, simple. Shoot the next one with ISO 200. 200, 100, that's one stop difference, one stop brighter. Let me give you another one. You take a shot with this shutter speed of 200, 1/200 of a second. And then you realize that, it's obvious underexposed. That means you're two stop underexposed. Take 200, drop it one stop, that's 1/100. Drop it one more stop, that's 1/50th of a second. That's how you fix it. Clicking it and stopping at 1/100 won't help because you're two stop underexposed. And then you get this shot. And then you realize that, this is about four stops. Simple. If you shot this at f11, drop it to f8. That's one stop brighter. Drop it one more time. 5.6. That's two stop brighter. Drop it one more time. f4. That's third stop. And drop it one more time. f2.8. And to be able to take the right photo in the next subsequent shot, second shot, you need to understand true stops. The true one stops. Look at the ISO. These are true one stops. The shutter speeds and the aperture. You need to memorize it. There's no easy pill for this. Well, that's it. Of course, I thought a very easy way how you remember all this in one of my e-learning on this website here. You should check it out. And now overexposure. Same thing. You have slightly overexposed. Obviously overexposed. Obvious overexposed means you show it to a non-photographer. They can say, it looks a little bit too bright. That's obvious. And then very overexposed. This is so overexposed, a blind dog can tell you it's overexposed. That's how bad it is. So same rule. One stop, two stop, more than three stops. And I've got a simple rule to share with you about overexposure. Take a look at this photo. If you notice that you can only see the nostrils and not the nose, you are definitely four stops overexposed. So in summary, today's lesson, you have three grades of overexposure, you have three grades of underexposure. So you need to master your true stops and know exactly how to increase or decrease by one, two, or three stops in photography. And that way you can nail exposure perfectly in no more than two clicks. If you like what you learned, share this video, subscribe to this channel, and hit the bell button. And hey, check out my e-learning and also YouTube exclusive membership. Hi, today's lesson, good photos in two clicks, okay. And that way you can nail exposure perfectly in two clicks under.
Two clicks under?
In no more than two clicks.